working on a particular approach that we already validated for other RNA viruses such as HIV, HCV, West Nile, dengue, chikungunya. The idea is to find a target which is not viral, but it's a protein inside the cell. And the advantage is that viral proteins can mutate, so the virus can become resistant to the drug, while cellular proteins do not mutate so often and so quickly. So if you find a suitable target that is a protein in the cell that is not essential for cell viability, but it's very important for viral replication, you can inhibit that protein and then you can make the cell resistant to the viral infection. So this is what we are now trying to do, trying to understand which cellular protein is essential for coronavirus replication and see whether we can inhibit. I would say the idea is a bit different because the vaccine is based on the introduction within the host, within the person, the patient, of fragments of the virus, proteins or other things that can stimulate the immune system. So the protection is given by immunity. While in our approach, we will treat infected patients with the drug, and this drug will prevent the virus to replicate within the cell. So that's the main difference. We are looking for a therapy, not for a preventive or prophylactic measure. Now we are treating patients here in Italy with a monoclonal antibody that has been developed to cure arthritis rheumatoidis. So it's an anti-inflammatory drug, which has proven to be very effective in treating patients with severe pneumonia due to coronavirus. Since it was an already approved drug, now we can already give it to the patient. So you see, the process can be very quick. Of course, it's unpredictable in our case because we still have to, let's say, validate our target. But hopefully, maybe within a year, we might have something. My advice is this pandemic will probably teach not only Italy, but other countries like Spain, France, that are, you know, suffering more or less the same problems, to think ahead, because these events will present again in future. It's unavoidable, that's nature. So we have to be prepared also to face extraordinary situations that now we realize do not only happen in Central Africa, but can also happen in Europe or United States. So we have to be prepared better for the next future to face another pandemic that will surely come.